It's amazing. Mr. Whitaker claimed that Russia didn't interfere with our elections, contrary to the conclusion of 17 intelligence agencies. When someone ignores the facts and just says these things, you know they're an ideologue. We are demanding that Mr. Whitaker recuse himself from the Russia investigation.
Do you think Mr. Whitaker needs to recuse himself from the Russian investigation?
I would say there may be reasons, but if the reason you're asking me is because as a private citizen he gave his opinion on certain things, then the answer is no.
Why?
The answer is no, because he was a private citizen. What's that got to do with his official duties? See, but it really doesn't matter, because right now he's going to go to the ethics people and ask if he's got to be recused. So that's going to answer itself.
That is the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, and before that, the top Senate Democrat, on whether the acting attorney general should recuse himself from the Mueller probe. Joining us now from Capitol Hill, members of the Judiciary and Foreign Relations Committees, Republican Senator Jeff Flake of Arizona and Democratic Senator Chris Coons of Delaware. Thank you both, gentlemen, for being on the show this morning. We're going to get to the issue of protecting the special counsel in just a moment, but I want to begin where we left off in the last segment. If you were talking to a soldier at the border, face to face, and the soldier asked you, why am I here? And is this mission a sham? What exactly would you say to that soldier eye to eye? Senator Flake, I'll start with you.
Well, I think it's unfortunate that we have the soldiers there. And frankly, in Arizona, they're stationed in Tucson, about 90 miles from the border. So they're not forward deployed actually on the border. So I think you can't call it anything but a stunt here. And it's unfortunate that they're going to be away from family during the holidays coming up. And we just don't know what really for. We don't know where the caravan, if it makes it north, is going to come. I think it could be handled by civilians that we have there in terms of Border Patrol and others. So I don't know what I could tell them other than shouldn't be doing this. And this wasn't an issue that Congress was involved in. It was an executive decision.
Senator Coons.
Mika, I've got someone on my staff, Lieutenant Brendan Mackey, who served in this exact mission when our National Guard unit got deployed to the border a number of years ago. When they are forward deployed at the border, it's difficult duty. And in this particular instance, given, as Senator Flake said, that they're sitting 90 miles from the border, and given that active duty military troops really aren't needed to block some caravan that we've got months of advance notice of, the Border Guard is fully capable of handling them. I'd have to look them in the eye and say thank you for your service, and I regret that our president is using you as a political stunt.
Senators, it's Willie Geist. I want to ask you about a different topic, and that is the Mueller investigation, the dynamics of which seem to have changed a bit now after the midterm elections with the Democrats taking over the House. What is your view of protecting Bob Mueller right now? Again, even since the midterm elections, the majority leader, Mitch McConnell, has said it's not necessary. We've asked for many months now what gives him the confidence to say that Donald Trump wouldn't find a way to fire Bob Mueller and to stop that investigation. What are you all prepared to do about it?
Well, we don't often pass bipartisan legislation out of the Senate Judiciary Committee, but we did in April of this year.
Right.
We passed legislation to protect Bob Mueller, protect the special counsel, by a vote of 14-7. That included the vote of the chairman, the Republican chairman of the committee. That has been awaiting Senate floor action now for 8 months. And the leader said at that time in April, well, you know, nobody's being fired. There's no danger for the special counsel. That is no longer the case now. Obviously, the firing of the attorney general ought to spur us to action. So today, we plan to go to the Senate floor and ask for unanimous consent to bring the bill up and pass it. Now, just one of our Senate colleagues can object, and we expect that one might, but we can bring it up again and again.
You know, frankly, the very day that President Trump forced the resignation of Jeff Sessions as Attorney General, he also again denounced Mueller's investigation as a hoax and tweeted that he could fire Mueller at any time. Why that's not enough of a warning for the majority leader, for our colleagues, I don't know. But the statements that Matt Whitaker, the acting attorney general, made on CNN when he was a commentator give me grave concern. I think we ought to take responsible bipartisan action here to prevent what would otherwise be a constitutional crisis.
So, Senator,
we can take this up and pass it easily today by unanimous consent.
Senator Flake, the president has fired his FBI director in James Comey. He's fired his attorney general in Jeff Sessions, as Senator Coons just said, put in an acting AG who's been outwardly and very publicly against the special counsel's investigation. So what does Leader McConnell say when you confront him, when you say, what gives you the confidence, Senator McConnell, to say that the president will not find a way to get rid of Bob Mueller? What's the argument against what you're proposing?
Well, I know in the past he has said that the president has said that he's not going to fire the special counsel.
And he just takes him at his word?
There's no indication. I guess so. I think that that's all we have now. He's fired the attorney general. He fired the ex-CIA director. I think the pattern here is clear, and he keeps making statements about this Russia issue being a hoax. So, and then this being a witch hunt. So I think we ought to take him at his word and actually pass this. As Senator Coons said, we have the votes to do it. I think every Democrat will vote for it, and a lot of Republicans as well. So we just need to bring it to the floor. We can bring it today. We can bring it again and again. And I think we plan to do so until we get it passed.
Hey, Senator Flake, about the only one wish that President Trump has been granted recently is the fact that you're not going to return to the United States Senate. What's your reaction now to the fact that you're going to be replaced in the Senate by a Democrat? And what do you have to say to President Trump about that?
Well, first, I congratulate Kyrsten Sinema on a good race, well run and won. In Arizona, Republicans have about a 200,000 person registration advantage still statewide. So nominally, we're a red state. We're just no longer a Trump state. We were once briefly, I guess, during the election, but it's clear that somebody who runs as a Trump candidate statewide will not win in Arizona. Arizona, as you've mentioned this morning, is now our delegation is six Democrats, five Republicans for the first time in a long, long time. So, and I interned for Dennis DeConcini, the last Democrat to be elected in Arizona, and that was a long time ago. But Arizona is we are Republican. It is a conservative state. It's just not this kind of Republican state.
Boy, just think, have you ever dreamt about the fact, probably, that a non-Trump Republican candidate named Flake, they would have called you Landslide Flake.
You know, I couldn't. It's difficult enough for a Trump skeptic to get through a Republican primary, let alone a Trump critic. So if I would have run the kind of race I've run in the past, unless I was willing to condone the president's behavior and endorse his policies, there's just no way you can get through a Republican primary, and I simply wasn't willing to do that.
Yamiche Alcindor has a question for you. Yamiche?
Senators, your professional and personal lives is a great story of bipartisanship, but now we're going to have a House controlled by Democrats and a Senate controlled by Republicans. Senator Flake, do you think that there's any chance that Republicans are going to be able to work with Democrats to get something done and even funding the government? And Senator Coons, do you think that Democrats should be willing to work with President Trump? Because some people were worried that they will hand him a victory if they do a big bill on something like infrastructure or trade.
Look, we can't spend our time worried about the next election. We have to focus on solving the problems that face the American people. What I heard up and down the state of Delaware in recent weeks is that folks really want us to work together. One of the reasons I'm grateful for the service of Senator Flake is the things we've been able to work together on overseas and here at home. I think if we show that we're willing to step forward and put on the table strong, real bills to address infrastructure, to address apprenticeships and jobs in the building trades to deal with the cost of health care and challenge the president to work with us in a bipartisan way and solve people's real problems. That'll end up having a positive effect in the next election, but that shouldn't be the reason to do it. Folks in our country have elected a Republican Senate and a Democratic House, and they want us to work together. That's what we ought to get busy doing.
Right. Senator. The issues are far too big to be solved by one party. Divided government is usually the best government, and that's what's worked traditionally, so I hope it can now.
Senator Flake, this last question is for you. If the bill today does not get a vote, is it possible that you can find a senator in your party to join you in bringing Senate business to a halt if the bill is not voted on?
You know, well, we've been having those discussions with some. With regard to nominees, there are still many sitting before the Judiciary Committee, where it takes only one person to stop things there. So all these things are obviously on the table.
Let me mention one other thing Jeff and I have just done on a bipartisan basis. President Trump directly challenged and criticized the chairman of the Fed in the run-up to the election. We've both been to Zimbabwe a number of times. That's more the sort of thing you expect to see in a country ruled by a dictator than in a free and open society like ours. The president shouldn't be interfering with the Fed and their decisions, and we sent a joint letter to the president urging him to stop that bad behavior.
All right, Senators Jeff Flake and Chris Coons, thank you both. And still ahead, Amazon has picked Long Island City as one of the sites for its second headquarters. We're going to talk to Mayor Bill de Blasio about that decision and what it means for New York, ahead on Morning Joe.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.